back to the shakes again, y'all. Wow, man, this just blows my mind once again. I'm just in awe. The making of this record that I just came out with called How Can It Be was from a kind of a crazy time in my life. My grandfather had just passed away, and I came back to Nashville after that and was trying to figure out what I was supposed to do in that season of my life. It was totally new. And God is so faithful. He just put a team around me, Paul Mabry, Jason Ingram, just helped me craft songs and move songs through. And it's amazing because when I think back on my grandfather and the songs that he inspired, it is all about love and the legacy of love that he left behind for our family to walk through as well. And that's the legacy that we all get to live as Christians. You know, they said, the word says that they'll know we are Christians by our love. And so when I was thinking back, I was laying in bed the other day thinking, oh man, if I win one of those things, I wonder what I'm going to say. Because we all plan what we're trying to say. And I was like, man, what do I want to talk about? And I just really felt like God was just saying, we as a body, we as Christians have legacy to leave, and it's all about the love of Christ to permeate through music and reach the hearts of all of the people out there that don't know him and those that do know him, but just to expand the body worldwide. And that's what music is all about, to leave this legacy of love. So thank you all the way to Centricity and Eaglemont, Janet, JRA, all the people that are a part of this. I'm so grateful. Thank you again.
She became a breakthrough artist with her declaration, Break Every Chain. To introduce our next song, please welcome the lovely Tasha Cobbs. So, turn on the news and it hits you. Another tragedy unfolds. Something unspeakable, insanity on the loose, hatred raging, a disaster, whether around the block or around the world. It could be overwhelming. What did Paul say? He said, we fix our eyes not on what is seen, but on what is unseen. Since what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. With a message of hope, here's Danny Cokey.
Thank you. pair of presenters. One is a legendary jazz saxophonist preaching the gospel according to jazz. The other is a legendary music producer and the founder of the contemporary music program right here at Lipscomb University. Welcome Kirk Whalum and Professor Charlie Peacock.
Going to do to become a legend?
That's what I want to know.
Just, you should know, man.
Just survive for 30 years, I guess. Now, Bill Gaither, he's a legend. That much of
you. That's a good one.
Well, we're here to present the award for Contemporary Urban Gospel Song of the Year.
And you check out these nominees, and you can hear the breadth of expression and contemporary urban gospel music. Man, I love it.
It's intense. It's playful, there's shout-outs and slow-building ballads, and this category has something for everyone.
Definitely something for me, man. So without further ado, check out this year's nominees for Contemporary Urban Song of the Year.
Contemporary Gospel Urban Song of the Year. Worth Fighting For, Brian Courtney Wilson. I Love God, featuring Vic Shiz, Erica Campbell. Flaws, Kiara Sheard. They Say Yes, featuring Beyonce and Kelly Rowland, Michelle Williams. No Greater Love, Smokey Norfolk.
And the double award goes to
I Love God. It's a Big Shiz by Erica Campbell, written by Warren Campbell, Erica Campbell, and the Son Daniel.
Oh my God. To upstage you. Now, one thing about me, I want Erica's flesh to die and God to arise in me so he always shines. I mean, and that just gives me another chance to tell people about Jesus, and that's all I really want to do. So I thank you so much for this. God bless you all, and let's keep telling the world that we truly are better together.